Students, today I am going to teach you very very important LAQ, that is question is chapter number 7 national income junior economics. Very very important question, gunshot question for 10 marks. What are the various methods for calculating national income? Explain them. What are the various methods for calculating national income? Explain them. Sir, having said that, what is the definition of national income means? The market value of all final goods and services produced annually within the geographical boundaries of the nation. That is called as national income. Now, sir, I will tell you, this one is gunshot question. Very, very, there is no paper without this question. Important for 10 marks. There are three methods for calculating national income. First one, output method. Second one, income method. And third one is expenditure method. Now, first ones are output method or product method. It is also known as inventory method or commodity service method. In this method, we find the market value of all final goods and services produced in a country in a year. That is called as national income. The market value of all final goods and services produced in a country in a year, sir, that is called as national income. The entire output of final goods and services are multiplied by their respective market prices to find out the gross national product, sir. What we have to do is, sir, suppose, just assume that here Q is the produced item, P is the market value. First, we should try to understand the national income definition. The market value of all final goods and services produced annually within a geographical boundaries of the nation. That is called as national income. Now, what is the formula of GNPs? The entire output multiplied with their respective market prices is called output method. For example, here Q is the produced item. Suppose, just assume that Santoor soaps are consisting of 25 rupees. Each Santoor soap multiplied with their 25 rupees. The entire output multiplied with their respective market prices is called output method. P1, price of the goods. Q1, quantity of the goods are. Here Q is the entire output multiplied with their respective market prices. To find out the GNP, here, sir, P1 into Q1 plus P2 into Q2 plus so on, PN into QN plus net income from abroad. Now, sir, you should try to understand what is the difference between GNP and GDP means. GDP name itself tells to you gross domestic product within the geographical borders of the nation. But in this GNP, net income from abroad included. In GDP, does not included. Same, sir, here GNP means gross national product. P is the price of the goods and services. Q is the quantity of the goods and services are produced. 1, 2 are the numbers. N are the various goods and service produced. The value of the intermediary goods. Just remember, here intermediary goods means under the process of production, the value of the intermediary goods and services should not be included. Only final goods and services should be taken into account. Just remember, only final goods are included in this. Intermediary goods are not included. Second method, income method. Here, sir, income method. In this method, the income earned by all factor of production. Just remember, here land, labor, capital, organization, these four are called factors of production. In this method, the income earned by all factor of production are aggregated to arrive at national income of a country. The four factor of production receives income in the form of rent, sir, wages. Wages means salaries. Instead of my service, I received salary from the Kakatiya institution. Rent, if you have 2-3 houses, sir, you are providing service and they are providing money for your house, sir. That is called as rent. Wages, interest and profit. each and every businessman, if you look around, every individual doing work because of profit. Every businessman doing work only for profit, sir. Income in the form of transfer payment. Just remember, here transfer payment means pensions, Shadi Mubarak scheme. These all are not included in this method. This is also known as national income and factor cost. Here NI is equal to national income. R means rent. W means wages. I means interest. P means profit. Expenditure method. Expenditure method, according to this method, the total expenditure incurred by the society, if you look around, every individual doing work because of profit. Every businessman doing work only for profit, sir. Income in the form of transfer payment. Just remember, here transfer payment means pensions, Shadi Mubarak scheme. These all are not included in this method. This is also known as national income and factor cost. Here NI is equal to national income. R means rent. W means wages. I means interest. P means profit. Expenditure method. Expenditure method, according to this method, the total expenditure incurred by the society in a particular year is added, sir. In this method, we add the personal consumption, expenditure of households, expenditure of the firms. Your firms means organization, companies, government purchasing of goods and services, and net exports. Just remember, first method, the entire output multiplied with their respective market prices is called output method. Second method, sir, we are getting income from four ways in the form of rent, wages, interest and profit. Expenditure method. According to this method, sir, expenditure of household, expenditure of farms, expenditure of government plus net exports. This method is based on the assumption that national income equals national expenditure. Care should be taken to include spending or expenditure made on final goods and services only. Just remember, sir, there are three methods: income method, output method, income method, and expenditure method. Here, output method means entire output multiplied with their respective market prices. This is a produced item multiplied with their respective market prices. P1 into Q1 plus, P2 into Q2 plus, so on. P3 into Q3 plus, so on. PN into QN plus, net income from abroad. Here, net income from abroad added, sir, in GDP does not include it. Intermediary goods and services should not be included. Here, sir, transfer payments not included. Here, expenditure of household, expenditure of farms, expenditure of government plus net export. This is the very, very important answer, sir. Thank you.